Today's severe weather is adding additional rain on top of areas hard hit by floodwaters just weeks ago. 4029 meteorologist Ross Ellett joins us from Fayetteville. And Ross, how are things there and how are the folks dealing with the severe weather on top of all the flooding that's been going on?
Well, Drew, there certainly is quite a bit of water to deal with, no doubt about it. Now, right now, we're at the West Fork of the White River right now. That's east of Fayetteville. Behind me, you can see those water levels certainly very high. This is really the same area in and around this location, and the watershed that feeds this river got about 2 to 3 inches of rainfall today, so those levels still very high, but nowhere near the flooding problems that we had just a few weeks back. In fact, behind me, you can see some of the debris still left over. The water had actually would pass over the roadways, left a lot of debris in its wake. Thankfully, it's not quite that bad at this point in time, but some of those residents and business owners, a little concern that things could get a little bit worse. I did speak with Joetta Copeland a little bit earlier today. She lives and operates Copeland's Bait Shop just off Highway 16. Last month's flood left a couple feet of water and mud in their home, and the forecast has them concerned once again.
Well, I'm thinking if it will slack off, we'll be all right. But if it comes another 3 or 4 inch rain, well, you'll probably get out of banks again.
Well, and the good news is, for at least for the time being, that rain has tapered off. Things are much calmer right now. But the bad news is another batch of rain not too far away. That'll move in later on this evening and overnight tonight, where perhaps 1 to 2 more inches of rain could fall. And the problem is rain chances are in the forecast all the way through Wednesday. And, Drew, it's interesting to know all this water that's here right now on the West Fork of the White River, this flows into Beaver Lake, and those lake levels are still very high at this time as well.
Yeah, that's right. Ross and I were out at Hobbs State Park yesterday traveling near the lake, and it's just unbelievable to see all of that water.